Assalamu alaikum, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ladies and gentlemen, let's continue our tutorials about early analysis program HAP software for cooling loads estimation. In this video, we're gonna complete our project here, our office. Let's start. This is our mold. Yeah, it's our project actually. Project. So it's mole or whatever you name it, it's no problem. And here preferences, and here the project, make it 2010 as we said. Yes. Here are our spaces, here office 1, guard station and pet shop. Maybe in the mall or office, no problem. We will not a problem. And this is the system. And should water single zone or multi-zone. EV system. Be three zones number in, and here's system components. We talked about it at the last two tutorials. Economizer, vanner, reclaim, pre-cool coil, preheat, humidification, dehumidification, central cooling, supply fan, duct system, and return fan. And here this the zone components. This is our talk right now. Okay, this is our system, and we have talked about how to name the system according to some serial number or kind of system. So shop water, if you deal with a single zone, this means that the three spaces you defined here will be treated as a single zone as you like. To treat the three spaces as single zone, or you make it VAV. And you have number of zones, three zones, or you make you can make it two zones. Two spaces will be considered as one zone, and one space and the other space, the third space, will be the other zone. So please be careful. If you make it VAV, it may be one zone. Let's continue with a single zone. You do not have a choice. And this is the system components, and here is the zone components. This is the third tab. We have here four choices or four tabs, sub tabs, spaces. You cannot uncheck it. Cannot uncheck it. Thermostats. You cannot uncheck it also, and supply terminals. Zone heating. You can check it or uncheck it. Okay, let's start with our space. According to this the general the air system type, the zone components will be one zone. If you change it to VAV, make it 3, here the zone components will be 3, okay? CAV single zone, and here the zone component, this is the office, add or remove, or double click, add, or double click, remove. So we do not have choices, this is always control and select all of them, like that, add, yes, remove, add, notice please this number. This number is the number of the copies of this space. Maybe add. Notice that you added you add here bit drop 3 times. Can if you make remove it. Here the office. Suppose that you have the only 3 spaces, these spaces are the only spaces you have in your project, so you add each of them, okay, and be careful, here is number, the number is 1, the number of copies 1 and 1, this means that you only have these 3 spaces, no additional spaces, okay, and will be treated as single zone. If you make it VAV, so we have here 3 spaces, or 3 zones, sorry, remove, and here suppose that the office is zone number 1 and guard station is zone number 2 and the bit shop will be zone number 3, okay, here so will the office will be treated as a zone, and this will be another zone and the other will be a zone, okay, this is the difference between the VAV and CAV, single zone and multi zones. But now the question is, what does this mean, what does this number mean? This number is the copies of the place or the space. If you make it 1, HAP will consider that there are only 3 spaces and they will be treated as single zone. If you actually have more than 3 spaces, suppose that you have another office or another pit shop or another space, you have 4 spaces. But the additional space, the internal load, the cooling load will is as the same as one of these spaces. Suppose you have another space and the internal loads, the cooling loads, are the same as the internal loads of the office. So we do not have to here. The space, we do not have to make new space. I know that you can make another office by duplicate. If you duplicate this office, you will have 4 spaces. 2 of them are different in the internal zones, and 2 of them are the internal zones are the same. You can make it, but there is another opinion. Notice that if you do not save, if you do not finish all the tabs, you cannot. If you go, okay, you cannot save it. So, I have to make it again. Add. Single zone. Okay. Now we have here 3 spaces, but suppose that we added we have 4 spaces. And the additional space, the space number one, number four, the internal loads are as the same as the internals of office, so we can make it two. This is the office. This number make it two. This means that you have here one and two spaces. We have four spaces. The guard station is a space, and the internal loads of it are different from the pit shop and the office. And the pit shop internal loads are different from guard station and the two offices or the two spaces. Okay, doesn't matter it is an office or there is another name. It may be an office or office and another office, or it may be an office and another another name. No problem. So we have here guard station, pit shop, and two spaces. Okay, HAP will consider that we have four spaces as a single zone. Okay, I hope it works with you. If you may have an additional space, you may have here three. So HAP will consider that we have a guard station, pit shop, and three other spaces, but they are as the same as in the internal loads. They are the same according to their internal loads. If you do not have this, you can make it one, so no problem. You can change the copies, number of copies. 3 or 5. We have 5 and the other two spaces, so you have here 7 spaces will be treated as single zone. Two of them have different internal loads, and 5 of them the internal loads of them are the same. Okay, so the cooling load will be multiplied by 5 and then added to this internal load and this internal load. That's it. Or you can make it, as I said, you can make here duplicate it. Yet office may not be an office, be any other thing. Barber. Okay. Here the system. Okay, system components. Here is the added bar, but you can treat it as another space with another space, but the internal load of it will be as the same as the office, because we the barber here is a duplicate, so it is a copy. Okay, we do not need to do this, so delete it. Here the space, the zones, office, the guard station, and pit shop. You can make it VAV, water, and here you have one zone. We're gonna make it that, suppose that we have two zones and three spaces. So zone number one, office and guard station, and zone number two will be the pit shop. No problem at all. Now we begin talking about thermostats, one of the most important tabs in systems. Here the thermostat and zone data. Okay, this check mark is very important. Here, if you check it, all zone stats set the same. This means that all the data that will be entered or that will that you will input it will be the same for every zones. For every zone we have here one zone, so the data will be the same if you check it. Okay, if you uncheck it, you only have the zone, one zone. But if you have more than zone, three zones, okay, and here zone components, spaces, and this is the pitch drop for zone number two, head, and the ground station, zone number three. Okay, there the thermostats. If you uncheck this, you will have zone one, zone three, and zone two. This means that you have to input the information for every zone. This is for zone one. Make it one, and zone two it will be different. Zone five. If any of these tabs are different from any tab, you have to define it by this method. You have to set every zone alone. Okay, but we'll have this is zone three. We only have CEV, zone components, office, guard station, and pet shop, just one zone and three spaces. So go to thermostat. Again, if you have many zones here and you wanna make all zones or all the information here are the same, there is no any difference in any of these tabs, you can check this all zone, and this means that the all zones one, the zone one, zone three, zone two will have the same information, the same conditions, the same T state, and for heating and cooling, and diversity factor, direct exhaust airflow. Here the shared area, actually it doesn't matter you check this or uncheck this, it is a shared data, okay, for every zone. Now we check it or uncheck it. We have one zone, zone zone. So here is the cooling state set points for the occupied condition and the unoccupied condition. We have talked about that. We talked about it in one of the last tutorials in the schedules. I remember this. The occupied degree Celsius is the required temperature inside the room. We want to make it 24. This is the temperature inside the zone. Okay. At the occupied state or the occupied condition. The occupied condition means that the people are inside the room. We have people, two people, three people, four people, whatever, 100 people, 1,000 people, no problem. And the unoccupied condition is the condition that you have nobody inside the room, but you wanna run the HVAC system. In other words, you may not have to shut down the HVAC system. You want to make the HVAC system running, and but you don't have to make the temperature 24. There is no people now, so we can make it 27. This means that the air conditioning system is running, but the air will be at 27 Celsius. This cools the air, and if you shut down the HVAC system, and we will know this in the next couple minutes, how can we activate the conditioned or unconditioned, how can activate it. Suppose that you do not have the unoccupied condition. You do not activate it, and the HVAC system is running only or runs only at the occupied conditions, and we shut it down when there is no people at the break. This means that the air will the temperature of the air will increase from 24 to it may reach 30 or more than this. This requires more energy, or more this will increase the cooling load, because when the people come back to the zone, the temperature will be 30 or 32, and the HVAC system will start again from scratch, and you will take time. Time is cost and electricity. So it is not recommended to deactivate the unoccupied zone. You have to make it to run the HVAC system. The cooling load will decrease slightly, and the cost will decrease. So you have here cooling T-stat set points, 24 when there is people inside the zone, and unoccupied. This means that you have a break, you do not have to run the HVAC system inside the zone with the with this condition. There is no people, but you have to run the HVAC system to not lose the cooling quality, okay, but make it 27 for saving cost and electricity. The same for the heating T-stat set points, the occupied. Notice that you have to make it lower than this, or the program will not work. We may make it 22 up to 23.9. You can make it. No, it will be 22. Okay. This is good, and the unoccupied, there is no people inside the zone, so you do not have to make the supply or the occupied zone. This is not the supply, this is the inside room temperature. We don't have to make it 22. We can decrease it. Notice that here we are in winter, and the outside temperature, it may be 17, 10. So the unoccupied may be lower than this, so we can make it 20. Okay. Another thing here is the T-stat throttling range. The throttling range actually is very important issue. Throttling range, if you make it 1 Kelvin, this means that suppose that you are in the summer and the occupied temperature is 24. If the inside room temperature is greater than 24, it may be 30, it may be 42, it may be 40, whatever, it is not 24. So the HVAC system will run. It is running, and the temperature decreases with time until you get 24. Here is the point that the HVAC system will stop. If it is DX system, the compressor will stop. If it is chilled water system, there is no cooling anymore. Okay, 24. Now the temperature is 24. So you know that the temperature will not stay 24 forever. No, it will increase. It will increase because the HVAC system now is stopped. 24, we reach to 24 plus 1. 24 plus 1. So now the temperature inside the room is 25. Here is the start point again of the HVAC system to decrease the temperature until we get 24 and then stop, and it will, the temperature will increase until it get 24 plus 1, 25, then start again and so on. Okay, it is not, and also in the heating T points, set points, the temperature now is 20, is lower than 22. We are in winter, and the occupied, the temperature now is lower than 22. It is 17. So the HVAC system heating will heat the zone and until you get to 22, then the HVAC system will stop until the temperature inside the zone will be 22 minus 1. It will be 21. Okay, then the HVAC system will run again to heat, to increase the temperature of the zone. This is the occupied conditions. And another thing about the throttling range, it is not recommended to make it very high or very low. You can make it half, 0.5 or 0.83, or maximum you can make it 1. This means that the HVAC system will stop and start between a good duration. Okay, it may take 15 minutes, it may take lower than this, or 20 minutes. This is according to the zone, according to your experience with this kind of systems. So, and if you make it 0.1 or 0.2, this means that the system will start until the occupied temperature reach to 24, and it will stop. And if the temperature will be is 24.2, and this is, you can get it in short time, so the system here will start and stop quickly, and this is not recommended. So we can make it 1 or 0.83, and it is not also recommended to make it 3 or 2 or 4. This will make problems. You will yes, it is not recommended 3. So the maximum you can make it 3, but it is not recommended. You will wait a long time between start the HVAC system and restart again. 24, if you make it 3, the HVAC system will start until it get 24 and stop. Increasing the temperature by 3, 24, the system will start again if the inside room temperature is 27, and this is not recommended. Make it 1. Here is the occupied and the unoccupied conditions. Now we're going to talk about the diversity factor. It's one of the most important steps. But I remembered, I have just remembered another thing. If you if you make this 24 and this death throttling range is 1, HAP software will try to solve this problem psychometrically in the psychometry chart in this way. HAP will take into consideration that reaching to 24 as an occupied temperature or more than this than it through the throttling zone is okay. This means that if you make this 24 and the throttling range is 1, if HAP software makes its calculations, if the software gets that the occupied temperature 24.5 or 24.9, it's okay. It's okay and no problem with the software itself. Okay, according to the throttling range, HAP will consider that reaching to 24.5 or 24.9 is within the range. But if you do not want this and you want only the temperature does not reach more than 24, okay, but you do not accept increasing the temperature more than 24, so if HAP software make the calculations and the occupied zone becomes 24.5 in the report, okay, but you do not want this, so what should you do? What you should do if you don't want the occupied temperature more than 24? You can make it 23 with throttling range 1. This means that HAP software will try and try and try to calculate the occupied to make its calculations, but the occupied temperature will not increase not be more than 24. It can reach 24 but no more within the throttling range. Here it is 23 and it will increase 23.1.2.3 up to 24. Then the HVAC system will run again until it reached 23 and it will increase up until 24, and that's it. If you if there is no problem if with increasing the temperature above 24, so if you make it here 24, HAP will may reach 24.9 and it's okay. So the occupied temperature the temperature of the occupied condition will reach more than 24. To sum up, I know that it may be complex. If you do not want, if you don't want the temperature more than 24 inside the room, you can make it 23 with throttling range 1. So the maximum temperature here that will reach that you can reach it by a HAP is 24, no more. If there is no problem with increasing the temperature more than 24, you can make here the occupied temperature here 24, and the HAP software will may reach to 25 in its calculations. Okay, no problem in this. And here we the diversity factor, actually it's a percentage. To understand the diversity factor, suppose that you have four spaces, one for meetings and one for the manager. It contains two people, and the third space is an office and another office. one of the offices contains two people, and the other office two people, and the manager contains four, or the sum of the people are is 10. Okay, so you have four spaces. One space is for meetings, and the other three spaces are for the employees and the manager. Okay, the number of people in reality is 10, and logically, you know that the meeting times, the meeting room will contain all the 10 people. So, and the other three spaces, there is nobody, there is no anybody, okay? So, what is the diversity factor? Actually, it depends on the diverse factor determines the cooling capacity of the cooling coil, and it will not affect the flow rate. In other words, in reality we have 10 people, and when they are in the meeting room, the other three spaces, 0 people, no one. Okay. But when you calculate the flow rate for the ventilation, or the amount of air that's required, HAP will consider that we have two people in the first office and two people in the second office and four people in the third office and 10 people in the meeting room. So theoretically we have 20 people, not 10. Okay, so the flow rate that is required will be for the 20 for the 20 people, not for the 10, because you have to take care of or take into consideration the 10 people when they are in the meeting room. Okay, so for the flow rate calculations, HAP will take into consideration the theoretical number of people. It will be 20, but actually we have only 10. Only 10. 20 is the summation of two people in the first office, and two in the second office, and four in the third office. So 4 plus 2 plus 2 are 10, and 10 inside the meeting room, but this is for an hour, for 2 hours, and so you have to take this into consideration. But for the cooling coil load, this does not happen if you take the diversity factor into consideration. If the diversity factor is 100%, the cooling coil will be calculated according the theoretical number 20. So the cooling load will be very high. So the diversity factor is very important. Suppose that we have 10 in reality, and those 10 come to the meeting room. So we have 10 people in the meeting room, and theoretically we have 10 in the meeting room and another 10. Okay, but it is theoretical. So the total amount, the total number of people is 20, and we have only 10. So divide 10 by 20, you get diversity factor 50%. What this mean? What does this mean? This mean that the cooling coil load will be calculated as follows. It will be calculated as the total number, the total theoretical number, 20 people, multiplied by 50%, multiplied by the scheduled percentage. Notice that we defined the schedules of lighting and people. So the cooling coil load will be calculated as 50% as diverse factor multiplied by the 20 people multiplied by the percentage that that we defined in the schedule definition. If you have the peak period, if you have in the during the peak period 80%, not 100% in the schedule, 80%, so the cooling coil load will be 20 people multiplied by 50% multiplied by 80%. So this actually is very important because it will decrease the cooling load coil without affecting the ventilation or the flow rate. The flow rate, I think this is the flow rate that is required for every space will not be affected. And that's it. The first factor, if you make it 60 according to the number of people theoretically, and in the reality you divide the real number by the theoretical number, and then you get a number, a percentage, multiply HAP will multiply the total number 20 people by the diverse factor multiplied by the percentage from the schedules. Okay, I think that in the peak or in the schedule, okay. That's it. This is the diverse factor. It's very important to take care of it. Ask your senior member, engineer about it, read about it to save energy, okay. Now, the direct exhaust airflow. Direct exhaust airflow, it is in liter per second. You have to determine it and input it. This means that you have exhaust air, but it exits from the zone without passing through the suspended ceiling or the plenum or the return duct. It is a direct exhaust airflow, like the exhaust airflow device. Yeah, another device. You install it inside the zone, and the air is being exhausted from it, okay, to the outside. So we have to determine this liter per second, because if the direct exhaust airflow rate is actually it has to be lower than the ventilation rate. But if the rate here is larger than the ventilation rate that's required for the zone, HAP will increase the amount of ventilation that's required for the zone that we defined it in the spaces. Every space has its own ventilation rate. If the direct exhaust airflow is higher than the ventilation rate, hourly analysis program will automatically increase the ventilation rate until it becomes equal to the direct exhaust airflow. I have to determine this, because HAP suppose that or assume that the building has a negative pressure. Inside the building, there is negative pressure that pushes the air from inside to the outside, and this is not recommended. It's not good. Okay, more amount of the air is being exhausted, and we do not have. We don't want this. So the direct exhaust airflow determines if the HAP will add ventilation or no problem. It will be not problem if the direct exhaust airflow is lower than ventilation rate, but it is not recommended or it's not good if it is higher than the ventilation rate. And if it is higher, HAP will increase the ventilation rate until it becomes equal to this. So if it is 20 liter per second will be added to the ventilation rate. The direct exhaust fan kilowatt, it is important only if you will calculate the cost of the project. This is for the cost, not for the cooling load, okay? Now you unchecked, you check all zones. So, well, we have one zone. If it is three zones, and here are the spaces. Pit shop, guard station, office. We have here three zones. The thermostat, uncheck this. So this is the information about the first zone. If there is any changes in one of these tabs or all of these tabs are different, you have to go to zone 2 and re-input the data here. Okay, but we will consider that we do not have these zones. Make it single zone for zone components, spaces. It's only one zone, and this is the office. We have here zone 1 with three spaces. Thermostat, check or uncheck it, will not it will not affect it. Okay, we make 1, 4, and 27, and two, 80. Okay, 5%, 20. Or anything that you you have to make it 5. It's a rough. Here is 1, 2 kilowatts. Here the thermal. This is the chair data. This is for every space, for every zone. The thermostat schedule, actually we we created FT schedule. Remember, please, this in the schedules we defined the FT schedule for thermostat at the last tutorials, at the schedule tutorials. So or you can create new schedule from here, but this fan thermostat, okay, as we did it, but we will make it here. The unoccupied cooling, we return, we come back again for the occupied or unoccupied. If you wanna the unoccupied condition to be cooled, or the HVAC system is still running and there is no body inside the zone, but you wanna cool the air to 27 Celsius, you have to make this available. If you don't wanna make this, you make this not available, and this means that the occupied temperature will be 24. If there is a break maybe at 12 o'clock and there is nobody inside the room, the HVAC system will be shut down, okay, and the temperature inside the zone may increase to 30 or 32 or more than this, and this is not recommended, so make it available. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we will continue to supply terminals, or actually here you can check it or uncheck it, but if you uncheck it, you have to, if you have more zones, you have to fill every zone alone. Okay, here is the zones, all zones. If you uncheck it, will be zone 1. If you have more zones, you will be find zone 1, 2 and 3 or more. Here is the CAV, so you have here the terminal type, diffuser or diffuser with reheat. It will not affect the loads or the calculations greatly. It's just to tell the software that we have a diffuser or an air outlet inside the room. And here is the minimum airflow. It is in liter per second per person, or per square meter, or per liter per second as a total, or air change per hour. This is very important because you have to determine the minimum airflow for this particular zone. Because if the air change, suppose that you have you calculated the air change in the spaces calculations, and the air change in the past or the spaces air change for this zone was 9 ACH, and you made it here 10 ACH, so automatically HAP will increase the 9 ACH here to 10, because this is the minimum airflow for this zone. Some standards requires less. In hospitals you have minimum airflow for this zone, so you can make it 10, and if the calculations are ACH are 9, it will increased by 1 ACH, so to make it 10. If the calculations say that the ACH here are 12, so there is no any changes will occur. Okay, this is for zone 1, diffuser or diffuser, it doesn't matter. But if you have here VAV system, this will change. VAV box or VAV box with reheat, series fan power mixing box with reheat, or Pearl fan mixing box, fan power mixing box with reheat in series or in Pearl. You have also to make it the minimum airflow 3 or 10, doesn't matter. It's according to the calculations, it's just example. The VAV box with reheat, and can you change it? But if you make it serious fan power mixing box with reheat, you have to determine the qualifications of the this fan by the pre-course power, total static or motor kilowatt, or watt per liter per second. It's recommended to use the total static pressure. Fan efficiency, of efficiency also have to get it accurately, and the design supply temperature for the reheating process, is it. So this is the series and the Pearl. Okay. This is just an example. Okay, here it's according to the breakpoint. Yes. According to this design supply temperature, please, you have to be careful about every thing here. Yes. Not with this. This 100%, this is 30%. Okay. 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 Here is the chair data. Doesn't matter you check this or uncheck this. If you have many zones, doesn't matter. The read called the heat source. It asks you electrical resistance or hot water or steam. And here is the reheat coil schedule. You have to activate. Here is all the months are activated. If you don't wanna any months, you have to deactivate it. So the reheat will only start or will run in April, May, June, July. Or here you can deactivate them. And activate this. Okay, it's up to your design. And here the zone heating units, it is an option, so you can check it or uncheck it. But please, before entering the zone heating units, you noticed that if I make it 110, it becomes red, and this is a warning. Okay, I'm not allowed to use this degree. 90, the same. 80, the same. So what's happening? Please, if you are supposed to this situation again, the first thing you think about it is to look at the maximum and the minimum values that are allowed. So here the maximum 65.5 and the minimum is 21.6. If you make it 10, no, make it 21.6, yes, 21.5, no, and 65.5, yes, 65.6, no. So please, to save your time, don't make what I did. First of all, you look at the maximum value and the minimum value. 65.5, okay. Okay. Here are the zone heating units. You may use an additional heating unit inside the room in some places that the temperature is very low. it may reach outside to minus 15, like Russia, or minus 9, minus 10, minus 5. So the HVAC system cannot supply you with the required heated air, and you can here use this zone heating unit as it is an additional device that you can use it in the extremely cold place. Also, if you have to change the data for every zone, you have to uncheck this if you if the data will not will be the same, you check this as we did in the thermostat, in the supply terminals. So we have here single zone, okay, zone, yeah. So check it or uncheck it, doesn't matter for all zones. Here the zone heating unit, we have none. You may have three zones and one of them there is no heating. Okay, the baseboard out air temperature control, fan coil out air temperature control, baseboard room to T-stat control, fan coil room T-stat control. This is the baseboard control. This is the baseboard. The baseboard it is an additional device that it is used to heat the system with the HVAC heating central system. This is the baseboard. And the fan coil, here the it is inside, it is installed inside the room without fan. And here is the fan coil, it is installed like this, and it contains a fan to push the air inside the room. This is the difference. And we have here a baseboard out air temperature control. Here, look at the maximum and the minimum. If you make it minus 2 or minus 5, this means that the HVAC system, the central heating system, will run normally. But the, if the outside air temperature get minus 5.1, minus 6, minus 8, minus 10, the additional zone heating unit will start in the surface. Okay, so this according to the outside air temperature. If it, it is lower than minus 5, minus 6, or minus 7, you will start the zone heating units. The zone heating units will start in parallel with the HVAC heating central system. And if you choose the fan coil, the baseboard room temperature, room T-stat control, you can, there is no any choices here. And the baseboard OA out air. Why? Because the baseboard room, it is according to the temperature inside the room. So we do not have to make the trip temperature. We do not need it, because it doesn't depend on it. If a baseboard outside, you have to determine the outside air temperature. The fan coil also, fan coil, you have to determine the trip temperature, minus 2. If the system, if the outside system temperature is minus 2.1 or minus 3 or minus 5, the additional, the zone heating unit will start in service in parallel with the central heating unit. And here you have to determine the design supply temperature for further information about it for the calculations, because this fan coil it contains a fan, and I think it you have to input this temperature. And the total static, or also as we did, the total static at 50, and the fan overall efficiency, the maximum and the minimum. If you choose here, the maximum and the minimum 65.5, and then minimum is minus 51.1. So take care of the range. Be careful. Big fan coil room. Here you do not have to input the trip temperature. You just have to input the design temperature, because it will depend on the design temperature inside the room. And this is the recommended, because suppose that your zone, the inside temperature is 10 and you want to make it 20 quickly, so the sensor will measure the temperature inside the zone, and if the temperature is now 10 and it becomes 20 after half an hour, the it's okay. So no problem. If the zone now is 10, the heating unit will start. I think this is the procedure, and if you can, you can open the manual to of the HAP help, or ask your senior engineer about it to get it. So the room thermostat control, doesn't matter the trip temperature is, it depends on the design supply temperature. It is now 10 and the additional device will start heating the zone with the central heating system until it be 20, and then the zone heating unit will stop, and so on. Okay, gentlemen, this is the 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the chair data, this hot water or electrical resistance or steam, and here all these masses are activated. If you want to deactivate one of them, click on this. So we now we deactivate OND and deactivate JFM. The only activated mouse is from April to September. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is the zone components. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of my tutorial. But before we finish it, I have to say, okay, I'm sorry. I opened it. Okay, and this. Yes. Okay, this is our system. The sizing status is not sized. So right click, and you have to view the input data, or view input data like this. This is the input data. We will discuss it in the next tutorial, inshallah, if Allah willings. And this is to print it or view input data. Every data you input, you can view it. And here you can print view design results, and we were gonna talk about how to generate the result, the report of the results, and how can we use the sizing data in the next tutorials, if Allah wishes. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is my tutorial about the system zone components. Now, after filling all the required data, you can click OK, and here is our system name. Please save it. Okay. And thank you very much. I hope it was good with you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.